Number one, the alligator people. In an old and lonely southern mansion, tucked away all by itself in an alligator-infested swamp, an eccentric old doctor opens a clinic for the hopelessly mangled, burned, and disfigured. The medical community laughs at him, but he, undismayed, effects miraculous cures by injecting his patients with his discovery. A drug, a serum, an essence, a rejuvenating life force extracted from alligators. Things are going great. His patients look and feel better than new. Until disturbing side effects begin to appear.
Doctor! Doctor! What was that horrible creature, all covered with scales and having a long tail, which scared me near to death and tried to kill you before slinking off into the swamp in its bathrobe? That, my dear, was one of my patients.
Number two, the brain suckers. An eccentric old scientist working alone in his lonely laboratory discovers a way to keep brains alive outside of their bodies. These lucky brains can now engage in the purely intellectual struggle with eternal questions, truly live the life of the mind, freed forever from dreary bodily concerns. What? Alas, the brains do need something to sustain them. Something the eccentric old scientist couldn't have foreseen and is powerless to control. They need to eat other brains. Soon, they grow little tentacles. Then they begin hopping about. Then they begin escaping. And when they find you, they suck your brain. And just then, hey, kid, let me see your ticket stub. I didn't have one. See, me and Danny Amendola had snuck into the movies. It was Halloween night. So the guy kicked us out just when the good part was coming. So we came in another door. He kicked us out again. We came in another door. He kicked us out again. We missed like half the movie. But finally he gave up, so I saw the end. It's all right, dear. The army has this place surrounded. Oh my gosh, those brains are multiplying so quickly, the army snipers can't keep up with them. I'm afraid, darn it, they're going to have to drop the A-bomb on the farmhouse.
But my father was in there.
That's all right. He would have wanted it this way.
Number three, the beast
from Haunted Cave. A plane has crashed in northern Canada. The survivors, all alone in the subarctic wilderness, band together, hoping against hope for rescue. One night, one of their party wanders off. Next morning, a search party is organized. All day they trudge through the snow, following the tracks of their companion. On and on they trudge. On and on. Trudging. Until at last, late in the day, they come upon signs of a struggle and a huge,
gigantic, unbelievably big footprint.
I can't go on. I think I broke a heel.
Okay, let's camp here. Try and get some sleep, everyone.
Wait a minute. I'm watching this thing on TV with my little brother, Tim. I said, Tim, if you were lost in the woods in northern Canada and you came across a footprint, I mean, this footprint, this thing was like 30 feet across. Would you camp right next to it? He said, No. Well, what would you do? I'd run. Well, that's what I think, too.
But they ignored us. That night, the beast takes another victim. Next morning, they trudge on. That night, the beast takes another victim. And so on. Will they never learn? Until, finally, they find the beast's cave. And either they kill it, or they're all killed by it.
I don't remember.
Number 4, the corpse grinders. Two filthy and devious businessmen own a cat food company.
Business is terrible. The skyrocketing costs of rat meat and fish heads is putting them out of business. They have an idea. Dig up corpses from the cemetery for free and grind them into cat food. They build a gigantic machine with blinking lights and a conveyor belt to put the bodies on and begin grinding. The cats love it. Business is great. The cats love it too much. They acquire a taste for human flesh.
Tabby. Here, kitty. Come here, Tabby. Here, Tabby. 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 Tabby.
Ah!
One lovely young woman becomes suspicious. She pays a visit to the factory.
Yes. I'm here about this cat food. It smells like death warmed over.
The two businessmen knock her out and throw her on the conveyor belt. But her boyfriend arrives just in time. And in the scuffle, knocks the businessmen into the grinder.